Good morning, student. Myself, Professor Gada Cases from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. So, students, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. So, from that subject, up to the last lecture, we have seen some topic from the unit number 3, that is the solar photovoltaic and its application. So, we have discussed some topics from solar photovoltaic and its application. And remaining topics we are going to discuss in the today's lecture. So first let us recover which topic we have seen up to the last lecture and which topics we have to see in this lecture. So the topics which we have discussed up to the last lecture, that are forming the PN junction solar cell, its advantages, disadvantages and its application we have seen up to the last lecture. Then we have seen solar structure of the solar cell. That also we have seen in the last lecture. And in the today's lecture, we are going to see the topics to be learned. That are types of solar modules, then PV array, solar cell equations, fill factor and maximum power, then equipment used in the solar photovoltaic plants. And the last topic we have to discuss from unit number 3 is that power conditioning equipments, that is inverters and regulators. So without wasting the times, we are going to start one by one all the topics. So first topic we are going to discuss in the today's lecture, that is the solar module and its types. So let's see, first understand what is the solar module. So let's see what is the solar module. Solar module, regarding to the solar module, every day we keep seeing the solar energy uses increasing. And the future also has many good things in this industry that we can avail. There are so many benefits solar module can address, from the remote power system for cabin, remote sensing to many more. But do you know what is a solar module is? That means what? That solar cells have the different applications in the different field. But do you know what is the solar module? Solar cell is different and solar module is different. So first understand what is the solar module. A single photovoltaic module or panel is an assembly of the connected solar cells. All of you understand? Single photovoltaic module or solar module is an assembly of connected solar cells that will absorb sunlight as a source of energy to develop the electricity. That means all of you understand that what is a solar module? Solar module is nothing but the combinations of the solar cells. All of you understand? So the group of PV modules, are also called as the PV panels, is wired into an extensive array called as a PV array to gain a required current and the voltage. That means in the today's lecture we are going to see what is the solar module and what is the PV array. All of you understand? So related to the solar module, we have seen what is the solar module and what is the PV array. So next we are going to study which are the different types of solar module. So one by one, let us understand which are the different modules. So three main types of solar modules are there. Out of that, first one is that monocrystalline solar module. So what is the monocrystalline solar module? That we will see. So related to that, that diagram is there. If you are able to see that diagram, there are all solar cells are connected to the single solar cell. So from that, the solar module is formed. So let's see what is the monocrystalline solar module. All of you have seen that diagram. So let's see what is a monocrystalline solar module. It is a solar module comprising monocrystalline solar cell. That means that module have monocrystalline solar cell. When sunlights fall on the monocrystalline solar module, the cell absorbs the energy and create an electrical field through a complicated process. Hence, it comprises of voltage and current, which is directly used to run the DC. That means direct current supply. All of you understand that? The panel cells have a pyramid pattern that offers a large surface area to collect the more energy from the sun rays. That means they have the pyramid pattern shape so that the area will be more, and due to the more area, the absorption of the energy is more. It reduces reflection and thereby increasing the absorption. That means if reflection of the light is get reduced, then absorption will be increased. So that solar panels will reduce the reflection and increase the absorption of the solar light. The cells are coated with the silicon nitrides. These panels have the lifespan up to the 25 to 30 years. That means that modules of the solar cell have the lifespan of the 25 to 30 years. They are useful in exhibiting more excellent heat resistance. They produced electricity is collected through the metal conductor printed into the cell. That means that metal conductor are also in the conducted into the conductors into the solar cells. All of you understand? And that is nothing but the diagram related to the monocrystalline solar modules. All of you understand? Next solar module is that polycrystalline solar modules. First one monocrystalline, second one polycrystalline solar module. So related to the polycrystalline solar module, one diagram is given, and if you are able to see that diagrams, that all cells are connected in the polycrystalline form, that is why it is a polycrystalline solar module. So related to the polycrystalline solar module, what they have said, polycrystalline solar modules are the solar module that consist of several crystals of the silicons in a single PV cell. That means in the single cell, several crystals of silicons are there. All of you understand that? Next, related to the polycrystalline solar module, polycrystalline PV panels covers 50% of the global production of the modules. That means out of the total modules, 50% modules are the polycrystalline solar modules. Made of the multiple photovoltaic cells, and each cell contain silicon crystals that functions as a semiconductor device. All of you understand? Then, as the photons from the sunlight falls on the p-n junction, it imparts the energy to the electrons to flow as an electric current. That means they are absorbing the energy from the photons which coming into the sunlight. So, the polycrystalline silicon is the most consolidated and tested photovoltaic technology. The conversion efficiency in the diffused light condition, that is on a cloudy day, is better than the monocrystalline modules. That means its efficiency is greater than the monocrystalline module in the cloudy day also. So polycrystalline cells are slightly cheaper than the monocrystalline ones, that are also cheaper, that is also advantageous. And first advantage we have seen that there is the more efficiency than the monocrystalline modules. And last point related to the polycrystalline solar module is that polycrystalline is having 25 year of lifespan. That means near around same as a monocrystalline solar module. All of you understand related to the polycrystalline solar module, and that is the diagram of the solar polycrystalline solar module. Then last types of the solar module is the thin film solar module. So if you see the diagrams, that are the all thin films which are over there, the solar module. So that is nothing but the thin film solar module. So related to the thin film solar module, what they have said, if there is one product that has the opportunity to benefit from the tariff on the crystalline silicon solar modules, it's the thin film module. All of you understand that? It is a good option for project with lesser power requirement but need for lightweight and portability. All of you understand where that thin film solar modules are used? It is an option for project with lesser power requirement. That means where lesser power we have to generate, there we can use the thin film solar module. And need the lightweight and portability also. So, the thin film technology have produced a maximum efficiency of 20.3%. So, the efficiency of the thin film technology is 20.3% with the most common material amorphous silicon at the 12.5%. So, thin film panel has 30% less than crystalline panels due to the module itself and its installation process. It is easy to handle, more flexible compared to the conventional solar technology. And last point related to the thin film solar module is that you can get quickly into the thin vapor sheets. All of you understand that is nothing but the thin film solar module. So that's are the three types of the solar module. First one monocrystalline, second one polycrystalline, and thin film solar modules. And related to the solar module we have seen, then related to the PV array, what is the PV array or solar photovoltaic array that we are going to see. So let's see what is the solar photovoltaic array. If photovoltaic solar panel are made up of individual photovoltaic cell connected together, then the solar photovoltaic array, also known as simple as solar array, is a system made up of group of solar panel connected together. That means solar array is nothing but the connection of the combination of the solar photovoltaic array. All of you understand? A photovoltaic array is therefore multiple solar panels electrically wired together to form much large PV installation called as an array. And in general, the larger the total surface area of the array, the more solar electricity it will be produced. All of you understand? That means larger the total surface area, light will be absorbed more and electricity will be generated in the more quantity. A complete photovoltaic system uses a photovoltaic array as the main source for the generation of electrical power supply. The amount of solar power produced by the single photovoltaic panel or module is not enough for the general use. The most manufacturers produce a standard photovoltaic panel with an output voltage of 12 volt to 20 volt. By connecting many single PV panels in the series for a higher voltage requirement and in parallel for a higher current requirement, the PV array will produce the desired power outputs. All of you understand? So that is nothing but the solar photovoltaic array. And here in the diagram, so the arrangement of the PV array is shown here, photovoltaic solar array is shown here. So if you are able to see at the top, there is a PV cell, that means single components. So that is a single solar cell. Below that, there will be the PV panel, that means photovoltaic cells, the number of photovoltaic cells are connected here. So that is the collection of the single solar cell connecting together. All of you understand? And at the bottom, there are connection of the two mini solar PV panels. So if we arrange or connect the number of PV panels, there will be the number of individual PV panels electrically connected together. So there is a combination of PV cells, then PV panels, and at the last there will be the PV array. All of you understand? That is nothing but the solar photovoltaic array. That is the arrangement of the solar cell or PV cells into the solar photovoltaic array. All of you understand? So in the today's lecture we have covered two topics. First one, solar modules, three types of solar module we have seen: polycrystalline, monocrystalline, polycrystalline, and last one is the thin film solar module. And also along with that we have seen what is the solar array or PV array. So related to the PV array we have seen some theory and its diagram also. So friends, today we will stop here for this lecture. Next topic we will continue into the next lecture. Thank you friends.